All right, guys, welcome to The Scoop, where we have real locker room talk with real athletes. And before we even get started, we have to do this, as we always do. We have to show you the resume of our guest today. And boy,
give him his roses.
So Nico Lester, first of all, this guy, born in Germany, dual citizenship, the real deal. Okay, he's played in Germany, Denmark, Finland, indoor football in the States, Spain, Sweden. In my research, if I did it right, in the last 10 to 11 years, he's played on 12 different teams out here, almost all of them at the top level in every country that he's played in. And that's since he started. And he started young, 19, 20 years old, playing in GFL 1 with the New Yorker Lions and then the Cologne Falcons. He started in the Mecca. But just look at his stats a little bit, guys. I got to give you a disclaimer. Really hard to find these stats.
I was about to say, I'm shocked right now myself.
A lot of different leagues, but I went through every league and I found as many stats as I could. That's why there's a lot of plus on there, because some leagues, there were no stats. So obviously the numbers will be a little bit higher, but over 7,800 total yards, all purpose, as a receiver, a running back, a kick returner, a punt returner, interception return yards, over 90 touchdowns as a receiver, as a running back. I think he even had a passing touchdown in there once. I'm not sure. He also had interceptions gone for touchdowns. Over 90 touchdowns in 5 different countries of 3 national championships. So he's a winner. He's not just stat padding. He's a winner, guys. He's a winner. Over 200 receptions, came into the GFL as a receiver type before being able to expand to that Swiss Army knife and playing both sides of the ball. 2019 Danish League MVP, over 175 tackles. So he's not just out there looking pretty on defense. He putting his face in the mud. I think he was top 2 on his team a couple times. Matter of fact, 15 interceptions. So, he's a playmaker. 42 passes defense. That means people try him because he's guarding the best players. That's what he does out there. 2013, German League champion. 2019, Danish League champion. 2020, Swedish League champion. Probably would have been the Spanish League champion in 2020, I think. I'm not mistaken. But with the battle out of Drax, but the season got cut short. He got 2 more championships on there. 2018, Mermaid Bowl runner-up when he was in Denmark. He's a 3-time team MVP, team and offensive MVP. 2 blocked kicks. I found those stats. 2016, Maple Bowl runner-up. And here's the kicker. He also has 1 forced fumble. So those are your stats for Nico Lester. And you can see
just a little bit of stats.
Yeah.
Just a little bit. It took a while to get through the stats because he has a lot of these stats, guys. This is one of the greats that we're talking to today. This is one of those guys who he's been almost everywhere and done almost everything and at the highest level. And we talked about this, I think, last week when we talked to another DB offensive player type. This is one of those guys that creates value for himself by being able to do more than just one position or one thing on a team. He's done everything that any team has ever asked him to do. So with that, welcome to The Scoop, Nico Lester, man. It's good to have you.
Thank you very much. Appreciate y'all having me here. But I'm pretty shocked. That's some good work you put in right there. All those stats and all that. I ain't never, ever seen it. And yeah, really appreciate it.
And if you're watching or listening, I put in some time to get these stats. Find these stats, see exactly what teams he was playing on. Because the internet is full of information, but it's not full of organized information. So don't get that confused. It's just out there. But let's get into the show. Next thing we'll talk about is a very interesting topic that isn't really talked about a lot. With the rise of sport and the popularity, there's a lot more European players and also a lot more dual athlete players who hold both European and American citizenship. And we're probably talking to the Mecca of that position, someone who was actually, raised in Germany, but, with that American upbringing as well at the same time. A lot of these guys, they get a passport. They're from the States. They just get a European passport through lineage, but they don't know what it's like. So when we're talking about this dual passport situation, A dual passport is a guy that, you know, he's not going to count against your American passport count. So a lot of duels are asked to, you know, play both sides of the ball, do a little bit more, but not necessarily compensated for that. You know, I mean, just being real, a lot of them are, you know, compensated like they're European, even though they're able to do more, or they're just compensated as an American, even though they're doing more. So just talking about the dual citizen athlete, like playing in all these different countries and you being one of them doing it at the highest level, what do you think about how that affects the game? I guess that's what I'm asking. How does it affect the game to have dual athletes? I guess I changed the topic. I'm sorry.
No, that's, I think it goes, you know, and being a dual passport myself, first of all, it's like, I think in the sense of dual passport is if you're coming to Europe, it is, if you played college, you know, you played college, but you have another heritage or you have another bloodline where you can get your other passport to play and count as a dual in Germany or in Finland, you know. For me personally, me growing up in Germany, you know, I grew up on base, so I got the American, I grew up like with the American culture, but I grew up, you know, playing football as a German, just with American head, you know, American head coach. And we actually had an American quarterback from playing from high school, you know, he was on the Air Base High School. So we had an American quarterback and we had other Americans too on the team, you know, as a junior. So as dual imports or dual passport, it is easy, way easier. But I don't consider myself, I have both passports, but obviously, you know, I didn't play college, for example. So all my knowledge came from the GFL and these coaches or, you know, going to arena and trying to, you know, get better in the game myself, you know, learning the game, the in and outs. So being a dual passport for any American or for anybody, you know, that's considered dual passport, it's always a plus because you're going to get offered 20, 30 plus offers every season or, you know, at least 15. You're going to get multiple offers because it's just easier. Especially if you're a good player, you're going to get it because teams can use you on both sides of the ball. And if you can play both sides of the ball, that's even bigger for every team, you know? So when it comes to compensation, I can't really talk on
that. Well, I mean, you don't have to get into the numbers, but
yeah.
Meanwhile, Nico's racking up the Euros over here.
Man, I wish.
What I'm really asking, when we talk about compensation, what I'm really asking is, you know, a dual passport, that's more value. So in general thinking, someone who's more value would be worth more. And like you said, you might get like 20 something offers, but about half of those, they're saying, oh, you're EU, so we're going to pay you like EU. Exactly. And it's like, that's not the case though. Like I'm not a EU, I'm someone who has a higher level of degree. Again, going off of your definition, you know, someone who's played in college and then gets a dual passport, like that's a very high level player. And just like any job, you're not paying for that person's time. You're paying for the knowledge or the skill set that they learned while they were, in college. Yeah. So that means they should get paid more. And you have guys who will come over here and they're like, oh man, I want to stay in Europe. I'm going to, go get me an Irish passport or go get me a this. And what they do is they come and stay over here, but then they try to become more of a European player than a dual passport. What they do is they're like, oh, well, I'm over here now, so I don't need to get paid as much. I can get paid less, et cetera, which is great and all for the team, but what does it do for their value as a player?
And, that's good you saying that because, a lot of guys, and I probably myself too, being, from Europe, from Germany. Like, to me, that's why I never – for me, to be honest, it was NFL or nothing. You get what I'm saying? Because all these
that's the American peanuts, mentality, though. Yeah,
all these other peanuts, these Euros or these whatever you're going to get as import players, it's not going to do nothing for you anyway, long term. So for me, it was always, okay, I have a job, Denmark, boom, with football. It's a nice hobby and a nice little income on the side, But me personally, should I maybe ask for more money because I'm playing both ways and I'm playing return, I'm on special teams? Like, does it cross my mind a lot?
That's what I'm talking about. The money of...
it crossed my mind a lot.
Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. Dual way players also getting, used up out there. That's what I used to be back in the day, two-way player. And that's a whole nother gig. I think we talked about this last time, too, actually, about, like, compensation for playing more positions. But that's what a dual passport offers you, is someone who can be on the field more often. And for that...
That's the question, I know what you're saying, trying to say.
Yeah, even if it's not playing both ways, you know, like, that means, like, you can add another American on the field, you know? Like, here in Finland, there's a weird rule where if you live here long enough, you count as the EU. So we had a team a couple of years ago that had 8 Americans on the field. Which, I mean, that's crazy, right? Yeah, but when you think about that, if you can put 8 Americans on the field, those guys who don't count as American, they're increasing the value of that team.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
they should be – I'm just saying, like, you know, that's something that should be thought about. Yeah. If you're listening or watching, you know, don't come at me talking about, well, Purvis want everybody to get broke off. I'm just saying, you know, pay people worth.
That's, yeah, exactly. To me, it always crossed my mind. But like I said, I always knew when I started this journey in general, I always knew that these Euros or whatever I'm going to get ain't going to go a long way anyways. You know, I can save here and there and I maybe have a little good saving that I can do something at the end. But for me, it was just, okay. If a team offers me whatever it is, 400 euros, 500, like whatever amount, like even if it's not a lot at all, like for me, it was more about the, you know,
the journey.
For playing football, for, you know, become a better man, brighten my horizon, learn a new language, see new culturistic things, you know, and keep adding to film.
Hey, speaking of which, how many languages do you know, man?
I definitely don't know Finnish. That's I don't speak Finnish. I've never gotten to that.
But I don't think anybody can learn Finnish in the time it takes.
I like the language. Hey, sorry to my Finnish friends and all the, but I couldn't learn it at the time. No. But I speak German, English. I know a little bit of French. Now I'm in Spain trying to, you know, get my Spanish back up too.
Value. So I was going to say, let me ask you this. You're someone who's played on a million different teams out there. So, you know, outside of just like the value aspect of it, you know, you're going into a situation where a team brings in a couple imports and stuff like that. So for you as a dual, you know, what's your mindset going into that situation? You know, are you thinking like, you know, these guys are getting paid more than me, but I need to prove my value? Or is it just like, I need to prove that I belong? Or is it just like, I know I'm better than these guys, or I'm just as good as these guys, you know, I'm going to come out here and ball also. Like, what's your mindset going into those situations? You've been through 12 different situations.
I guess at the beginning of my career, of course, you know, I was really, you know, still am now, but I was young. So I was really, you know, competitive no matter what. I still am. Don't get me wrong. But I was mentally also like, yo, why is this guy getting more than me, bro, when I'm, you know, just as good, if not even better, and I'm playing more than this guy, and he's getting paid more, you know? But then, like I said, at the end of the day, it just became more like, I love playing this game. Like, I truly love this game. So it was not that much about the money no more, you know? And it became more, okay, I just need to be the best player I can be, and that is it. And with moving, like, this journey that I took, like I said, was more about me becoming a better person and a man in general, forming myself, trying to figure out who I am in general, you know? So that's why I took this journey, because it was-
Let me ask you this about your journey though, okay? Because throw all the political rightness on the side. You a dog, you a competitive beast, you got fire. Yeah. I've seen you play. Let me ask you this. When someone looks and see you play, do you want them to look at you and say, okay, that's a good player? Or do you want them to look and say, that's one of the best players?
I want to be truly honest. My goal was to be the best player to ever come out of Europe. And I'm going to be straight up now on the scoop. And to be honest too, I truly feel that way. Like, I don't know if anybody from Germany, you know, or in general, not the playing wise, but playing both ways in multiple positions. And
if you need it, I'm gonna tell you right now, I co-signed on that. First time I ever saw Nico Lester play was 2016, Senioki Crocodiles here in Finland. And I was like, okay, number 23, playing both sides of the ball. That must be an American. He out there balling. He probably be MVP of the league. And then like 2 days later, someone was like, you know, he's not American, right? And I was like, what do you mean he's not American?
Yeah.
I seen him. I seen him take off his helmet. Yeah, he American. I seen him talking in English. He American. What you talking about? And for me, and you know, being an American here and seeing a lot of different players play internationally with the dual citizen athletes as well, that's one of the highest like nods that I can give somebody when I see them on the field, is that not only am I saying that you're like a good player or you're good for your team, is that, you know, that's an American level player. Like, he's one of the best. And you're one of the first ones I saw. You're not the only one. There's there's other players out here who are even dual or even some European players where mm-hmm. when you turn on the tape and you see that player is one of the best players on the field, that's saying something here in Europe, because the level is played very highly. And you played in the Maple mm-hmm. League. There's a lot of imports out there, a lot of imports, a lot of duels, a lot of Europeans. So playing at a high level, like, you have to stand out. And that's something that, as a competitive, and, you know, like I said, you got that dog and you I've seen you on the field, you stand out. You always stand out. And that's something that you can kind of take to the bank, even if the NFL might not be in the cards at this moment, but you can always look back and say, hey, whenever somebody turned on the film, they knew who I was. Like, I didn't tell them who I was. I didn't have to say, hey, I went to this guy.
Yeah, it's exactly.
Like, you know who he is. Yeah. Like,
and the crazy thing is that, like, yeah, he's recognized all over. I remember when we did the Revive series back when, you know, leagues were starting to open again because of COVID, and just talking to some people and, you know, getting some lists. And one of the people put out a top five. I got a DM right away that said, if Nico Lester's not in the top five, this top five is shit. Because I think it was you and Breon Allen for one and two. And I forgot what league it was in, excuse me. But, you know, just that recognition of, like, your peers knowing and seeing how you play, I mean, that speaks for itself.
Yeah, and that, for me, that's the biggest, like, that's why I'm not, you see my social media, for example, like, it's all, you know, football, like, because that's what I love doing. But I'm not out here on social media talking, you know, too much. That's what I'm saying, like, about football, you know, in a sense of, like,
trying to. You're not worried about a brand or anything. I'm just trying to ball.
I'm not that type of, never been that type of player that gets involved into these talks and trash talks and, hey, who got the fastest 40 in Europe and all that stuff. You know, where I'm like, all right, if a show like that go down, I'm going to sign up for it and I'm going to just show up, you know, but I'm not going to talk, you know, in the forum or in the chat, because I just, you know, believe, like, don't like talking. You know what I mean? That's what I'm saying. I just love playing the game. And if I am good to others, nice, you know, but to me, I just want to always be the best player I can be coming out of Europe ever, you know? So that's why I really try to just be able to play any position for the team that I can, that I'm on, and help the team win. That's really winning is the MO for
the ultimate goal. I gotta be honest though, with you playing in the Barcelona Dragons this upcoming season, the ELF. I personally, this is me just talking personally here, guys. It warms my heart because, like I said, I first saw you in 2016, and if I'm making a list, you making my top five every year. And that's on record.
Appreciate that.
Nico Lester in my top five every year. Like, I ain't seen no one that could do it better. I mean, it's gonna be a tight top five, but you know, you own it. I know some guys. But one interesting thing, you know, since you've kind of made that move into the Denmark area, you know, this is the social media world that we're in. You know, I feel like people, you know, they forgot about you because you was out there. I feel like even someone that you brought up earlier, Clay, Breon Allen, like, he's coming to Finland this year. Like,
yeah,
Denmark and even Sweden, those areas don't get looked at as much by the mainland in Europe. So you can go there and be great, and people think, oh, well, there's only one good team or there's two good teams. Like, people forget that before you got over there with the Razorbacks, the Copenhagen Towers were running through that league. And the Razorbacks are one of the more successful teams in that country as well. But they were in a drought before you got there. And now the last 3 years, they've been a top two, top three team. I don't know how it would have worked out in the playoffs. But, you know, that's something that people don't realize because they don't, like, watch, you know, this Nordic country or this country or that country. So when you – and even when you go to Spain, you know, a lot of people they discount what's happening in Spain. You know, like, oh, the local is bad. You could just be an import. They go there for vacation, blase, blase. But when you go into ELF, you're going to be playing against some of the best players in
the Europe.
Like, so your name is going to pop up all over again. And I'm saying it warmed my heart personally because I've seen your journey and I've known you to be the player you are. But it's really good that something like you playing on this team, the ELF, is going to put you back on that like higher platform so people can understand that, you know, Nico Lester is a dog. It needs to be said. I'm just saying.
And that's why I think,
I'm going to say it. He don't
appreciate
have to say it.
I'm going to say it. I appreciate it a lot. But that's what I'm saying. Like, I'd rather have you say, you know, people watching me. Like, I'm not that type to be like, hey, I'm out here. You know, like, I just don't do it. And I think that's why I believe in karma. I believe in everything, you know, for reason. I believe that God blessed me with this gift. And I don't need to. I can be have the dog mentality. And I'm going to have it, you know, like on the field, like every snap. You know, I don't care. You can even you can talk shit to me. It don't affect my game. It won't matter. You might get a 1-2 words back, but you ain't going to get in my head. You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, I just believe in, you know, that because I started late, what, 17? My first season was, when I was 17, 18 years old. So I just believe that God blessed me with a gift and I don't need to use this gift to, you know, go out here and boom, 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 like showboat too much, you know, like, because I believe that injuries, like, I don't know, to me, I'm really super, so I believe injuries.
You believe in that juju, that's what it is.
Exactly. And that's why, because if you think about it, I've been playing both ways now for, what, 5 years, going on 6 years. So for these teams, both ways. So I'm taking, I don't know how many snaps, you know, per game, for example. And I haven't had a, knock on wood, my bad, I haven't had a serious injury yet, you know, and I believe that's because of that, because I just hold myself to, you know, this standard where I don't need to. Does it hurt me that I never got, like you said, purpose? Does it hurt me maybe that I hurt me? No, but am I disappointed that I never really get the recognition kind of in Europe that I think I should be getting? Yeah,
but it's coming, my brother. That's what's good. It's coming. Exactly. I'm if you watching or listening, mark my words. People are going to be talking about Nico Lester this year. They're going to say, oh, those Dragons, Nico, your name will come up every time they name somebody who's a dynamic or key player for that team. And it might come up as one of the best in the league. I can't speak too much on that because I don't know how everybody else is going to play.
Exactly.
But I can tell you that your name will be in the mix and it's going to be great. And believe me, when they put your name out there, you're going to see me sharing, liking, saying I told you so as I do. With you and a couple of other guys that I co-signed full-heartedly, you know?
Yep.
That's a great thing. And
it is a great
thing. It's a testament to you and the way that you've played because, like you said, it's disappointing that, you know, not being in the limelight and playing at a high level still, maybe you don't get the recognition that you deserve. But, you know, it's karma. You not got hurt. You've stayed healthy. And you've continued to get better. So now you're going to get your roses, you know?
Exactly. Yeah, most definitely.
I'm looking forward to it. That's why, like, I know there's a lot of, you know, not hate, but a lot of, you know, disconnection going on with this new league starting. But if you really look at it, if I myself, when I started 2007-08, that's actually when the NFL Europe just ended, you know, when I started. And like I said, like, for me, it was like any sports I did, you know, and I was doing a lot of sports before even playing American football, like organized American football. Basketball, badminton, table tennis, you know, kung fu, dead, you know, martial arts. So I was doing
things, love this badminton, brother.
Yeah,
I get which is a badminton.
You know, so for me, it always, I always want anything I did 100%, and I wanted to be the best at it for myself, you know, and compete. I was always like that in sports. So NFL Europe stopped, and I was like, damn, there's no, you know, what is the next highest thing?
What's the next one? Yeah.
You know, where, you know, like I said, American mentality is like, where's the next hot thing I can go to get this bread, you know, for the fam, you know? So I'm like, okay, shit, that was the next stop. That's a long step from Germany, you know? And so I'm like, how am I going to make this, bro? How am I going to make this on my own too, like at the time? So I just came up, man, with the plan. I was like, I just have to become the best player to ever play Europe both ways. And maybe get a look or, you know, a coach to recognize it and see it and be like, hey, let's give this guy a workout, you know? Because even, fun fact, like the international players pathway, the program, like I signed up for it and everything, and then I get it, and the CFL combine. So I got invited to, and then I get from the international players pathway and from the CFL, they both text me because I'm a dual passport. I have an American passport. I can't participate in any of those, you know, events.
That makes sense. Cause I was wondering about that. Cause
bro, so yeah.
That hurt me right there.
You know, what are you, 6'2", 210?
Like, yeah.
Cornerback? That's ooh.
Well, I'm like, that's what I'm saying. It's good, but it was also bad in that sense because, like, in my head, I'm like, man, I'm coming to this combine. I'm going to rock these numbers, like, for the show, the Eldra, you know? Like, I'm going to give you a show.
That's crazy.
You know? And it hurt me in that sense where I'm like, I'm trying to tell them, I haven't even played college. Like, all my skill set I learned in Europe. Like, so why does that even matter if, you know, for me to play in the
event? That's politics, man.
That's exactly. So I don't know. And that's why I don't play politics no more. And I just enjoy this journey, man, and just love the game, man, and play football.
Yeah.
Whatever happens after happens, you know.
Have you checked out Kano's ready-to-wear collection? It's Kano's top-notch quality, but it's teamwear made custom for you and your team, so you can rep your squad now. Okay, here we go. That's it for us today on The Scoop. Keeping the locker room talk real, as always. I want to thank our guest, Nico Lester, today. Of course, man, you're one of my favorites, so it's always great to have you on. Glad you could take the time and, you know, kick it with us and chop it up and talk sports, talk football. That's what we're talking. Mm-hmm. We're talking football and life. Just want to let you know, man, that, you know, we're rooting for you. I've already said it on this before, but, you know, I'm very personally invested in seeing you play at the highest level in Europe this year. And be able to, you know, get your roses from the rest of the world outside of just me. So we wish you the best, man, and whatever you got going outside of football as well. You know, you are more than just a football player to us. We know that you are a man. You have things going on. And just wish you nothing but the best in your future, man.
Thank you. You're welcome. Appreciate you having me on. All the words, especially like I said, go back to the statistics. I've never kept track of stats, so I got to put it out there again. Great work for that, too. I might have to screenshot it.
I'll send it to you.
Okay,
no problem.
But
it's easy.
And no, it was all love talking to y'all. I really appreciate y'all having me on.
Yeah, we appreciate it, boss. I mean, you got any excited for what the future holds, but you got any shout outs or any projects you're working on outside of football?
I think I'll keep that, you know, keep that to myself right now.
Yeah.
I don't really good. I don't talk too much on process what I'm working on, you know. Try to keep
it good, boss.
But no, shout out to Shout out to the ELF. Shout out to Barcelona Drax, by the way. About to head into the semifinal. And shout out to all the, you know, listeners on The Scoop. That's mainly everything, bro.
All right,
yes,
man.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Anything else from you, Jamal?
I'm good, man.
All right. So thanks for watching the show on YouTube or listening to the podcast outlet. Be sure to subscribe to the Athletes Forum YouTube channel or American Football in Finland podcast channel. You know, that podcast is on like 85 different outlets. So wherever you get your podcast, just click it. And on YouTube, just type in The Scoop Athletes Forum, and we're going to pop up. I promise you. We out here, okay? Subscribe to either outlet. Follow us on those, and you'll get the updates every week, video or audio. Whenever we publish, you'll get a little, you know, notification and stuff. You can also follow us on Twitter, at The Scoop AF, on Instagram, at Athletes Forum, or on Facebook, at Athletes Forum. And also, by following us on all these channels, you have a chance to win teamwear swag provided by our sponsor, the KNOA. Be sure to follow instructions for the contest below in the description, and also on the audio, it'll be in the description, the contest rules. So that's it for us, and we'll see you next week.
Peace.
Peace.